Hi, hello. Namaste. Welcome back to Needs of Children. In this session, we are going to get the information about 8th Standard Social Science English Medium Business Studies Chapter Number 1, Continued Part of Components of Business Studies. Let's come to the In the previous session, we get the information about introduction for the lesson, economic activities, types of economic activities, the concept of exchange, evolution and growth of commerce. In that, the very important stages like hunting and fishing stage, pastoral stage, agricultural stage, handicrafts stage. Let's come to the In this session, we are going to get the information about barter system stage. The concept of barter system stage. The division of labor enabled quick production of goods. The goods produced were directly exchanged. So, as in the concept of division of labor, it is came into existed in the agricultural stage, that it is continued in the handicrafts stage. When comes to the barter system, here the goods produced were directly started exchanged. The direct exchange of goods for goods or other things is called barter system of exchange. That is the meaning of barter system. Some of the very important problems were created under the barter system of exchange. Among that, the first one, lack of double coincidence of wants. That means, if two parties exchange goods with each other, we call it coincidence of wants. But such double coincidence was rarely found. For example, like A, take it as Annappa has paddy and he wants wheat. B for Basanna, he has wheat but he wants jowar, and B for Basanna is not prepared to take paddy. So this is the concept of lack of double coincidence of wants. And the next one, lack of common measures of value. It was very difficult to decide the quality of one commodity to another. For example, one cow, how many sheep, or one measure of wheat, how many measures of jowar. So this was very difficult to divide the value. It was very difficult, so that is become as one of the second problem. And the third one, difficulty of subdivision. Like it was very difficult to divide some animals or things. Example, to divide the cow for some sheep. So that is also one of the major problem has become difficulty of subdivision. And the next, difficulty to store the goods or to transport. The movement of goods from one place to another place was also a problem. It was also difficult to preserve some goods over a long period, like perishable things. Either it is a vegetables, either it is a milk products. So these are the perishable things we cannot preserve for many days. So such kind of things it is preserved for a long period of time of duration, and some things it is very difficult to transport. So such kind of some of the storage problem and transportation problems it has been created. Somehow, finally, whatever the problems we are faced to overcome the difficulties of barter system of exchange, many mediums of exchange were used, like the skins of animals, cowrie shells, etc. Later, the metals were used as a medium of exchange. The metals were brought to particular shape and weight and used as exchange of medium. Later, the copper, silver, and gold coins came into existence. So this, the very important stage, considered as the money economy stage. Somehow, whatever the difficulties we faced in the barter system, the solution that is in the money and economy stage. Whereas here also some difficulties were experienced, like mainly the transportation, because coins, either it is a gold, copper, silver, it is very difficult to carry. So that here also some of the problems were experienced. Later, when paper money came to be used, the paper money is a token money which generally comprises of bank notes issued by the central bank of the country. It has full support of the government. So overall, whatever the problems we are faced in the business, for all the problems, for difficulties, we put the full stop with the help of paper money. Nowadays, bank money in the form of checks, drafts, bills, credit cards, debit cards are playing a very important role for everyone for the growth and development of the commerce. After money and economy stage, there will be a town economy stage came into existed. The introduction of bank money as medium of exchange resulted in the fast growth of commerce. Obviously, when it is money played a very important role for all the business and commerce development. People began to produce more and more goods. The producers started meeting at a fixed place at periodical intervals for exchange purpose. So such kind of where they are meeting each other, where they are fixed that place, those places are came to be called as local markets. Gradually, these local markets developed into towns and centers to supply goods, and the merchants came into existence. They invited the craftsmen to particular place, collected raw materials and started producing finished products and supplied it to the consumers. So during this stage, commerce developed largely and markets extended far and wide. Anyhow, money economy stage played a very important role for the development of town economy stage. At last, the international trade stage. As we already experienced that 15th and 16th centuries, geographical discoveries took place. Anyhow, Columbus discovered America, Vasco da Gama discovered the new sea route to India. Magellan, a Portuguese navigator, with the help of the King of Spain, set his sail to circumnavigate the world. He crossed over the southern cape of South America and reached to Pacific Ocean. He reached Philippine Island and was killed by locals. But his ship Victoria returned to Spain after 3 years. This was the first ship which sailed around the world. That is what we say, Magellan was the first whose ship sailed around the world. As a result of these are all the efforts, majorly the geographical discoveries. After this results the Industrial Revolution, which took place in England, and geographical discoveries helped for large scale production of goods, not only for the local markets but also for other countries. Standardized goods were produced with the help of machines. Revolution in transportation with the help of industrial revolution. Communication helped for the expansion of market. The production of goods was carried out not only for the national markets but also for the international markets. So here geographical discoveries and industrial revolution played a very significant role for the development of international trade stage. So these are the very important evolution and growth of commerce stages. So let's come to the concept of role of business and commerce in economic development. We know that the concept of trade. Trade is nothing but buying and selling of goods and services. On the other hand, commerce includes trade and also aids to trade, auxiliaries to trade. So here the trade is nothing but buying and selling of goods. Concept of commerce, it includes trade and also aids to trade. So what are the aids to trade? We are going to get it now. The aids to trade includes transport, banks, warehouse facilities, advertisements, agencies, insurance, etc. Traders, warehouse facilities supply goods to the consumers according to their daily needs. Traders supply goods to consumers according to their daily needs. They provide some services also. For the smooth conduct of business, transportation helps. For the movement of goods from traders supply goods to consumers according to their daily needs. They provide some services also. For the smooth conduct of business, transportation helps for the movement goods from one place to another place. Whereas banks helps to provide financial assistance. Sometimes during the transit or during the storage of goods are exposed to some damage or loss. These are all we are going to be get with the help of insurance companies cover the loss while goods are in transit or storage. Warehouses help to store goods and services and bridge the gap between production and consumption. Whereas advertisement helps to give information about the goods produced. So this is like role and business of commerce in the economic development. At last, so let's come to what are the benefits of commerce. Commerce, to sum up, it is a responsible for smooth and continuous supply of the goods and consumers. Whereas commerce helps in bringing the factors required for the establishment of industries. For any industries needs to be some of the factors, like either it is a place, either it is a machines, either it is a laborers. So these are all the factors are required for the establishment of industries. Commerce will helps to establishment of industries, and it also helps to the different parts of the world very closer, thereby creating one market. And commerce helps the traders to become more adventurous themselves. They are involving in the taste mindset of the consumers, so that according to their taste, their mindset, the traders, producers will involving in more and more adventurous activities. Commerce equalizes the prices, blends the ideas and cultures, and helps for national as well as international integration. That is the very important benefit we are going to be get from the commerce. And even it helps the government through paying the rates, taxes and also duties. Anyhow, commerce, it is a good source of income for the government. So these are the benefits we are going to be get from commerce. Let's come to the development of commerce during the 21st century. How commerce is getting the development in 21st century. 21st century is called the age of information technology because of internet banking, mobile banking, privatization of insurance, advancement of telecommunication services, online shopping, e-commerce, better transportation facilities, electronic media and such others have spread all over the world. So, through the technological advancements, the entire world has become a global village now. That is the reason to manage these are all the things needs to be the knowledge of information technology. MNCs like multinational companies have spread their business in many countries. They help to increase production and supply of goods to the world market. These companies produce specialized goods on the large scale and their prices are competitive. And the whole commerce is developing at a greater speed. Information technology is playing a very important role for the development of the commerce. So this is about the concept of the lesson, the components of business and studies. So in this session we get the information about concept of evolution and growth of commerce, in that barter system of exchange, money and economy stage, town economy stage, international trade stage, role of business and commerce in economic development, development of commerce during 21st century. I hope you have understood what I taught till now. In case if you have any doubts related to this lesson, please comment in the comment box. I will solve your doubts. That's it about today's session, and I will come back with the next video. Until, keep watching my channel. Thank you. See you in the next session. Bye-bye. Take care.